wealthiest black man in the world is a Nigerian. He's the wealthiest black man in the world. He's a Muslim, he's not a Christian. He says sugar, he says indomie, he says cement, he says salt. He's worth almost $20 billion. How did he become rich? There's a great man of God called late Archbishop Benson Idahosa in Benin. Archbishop Idahosa had two white visitors who came to visit him, men of God. And they were going back from Benin to Lagos State to fly out to America. And the plane was full. And the Archbishop got there and said, these two men have to be in this plane so they can connect their flight. And they said, sorry, sir, it's full. So the pilot said, Papa, if you can come and tell them, if two people can agree to come down, so you can put in your men. Archbishop said, don't worry. He climbed the plane. He said, I have two people who are flying. There are two people here that will not fly today. That's how the Archbishop talks. He said, you will come down and my two guests will fly. There were Christians there, I'm sure. They crossed their leg. I'm sure they were quoting scripture. Nobody can take my portion. Anywhere the sole of my feet tread the poor, I possess.
Yes, sir.
This man, 1991, this man looked at his PA. He said, this is a man of God talking. Let's come down. We'll travel tomorrow. And they came down. And the Archbishop put his two white guests. When the Archbishop was leaving, he turned to him. He said, who are you? He said, I'm a young businessman. I'm struggling. And the Archbishop said, because you stood up for me, the whole world will stand up for you.
Amen.
When he tells his story, he said that was his turning point. And I'm sure there were many Christians there.
Yes, sir.
Who sat on their seats quoting scripture. I go nowhere. It's my portion. I'm sure some will be criticizing him. How can a man of God be talking like this? No human sympathy. No human sympathy. No empathy. Empathy. And they are still speaking that English thing now. And somebody is the wealthiest black man around. Because that word put him into favor.